Hi friends, my name is Jim Southard, and I have this opportunity to talk to you about what I call photography that reaches people. I firmly believe that the best photography happens when a photographer is in a state of awareness that not necessarily the other people around him are, and he can use it in his art and in his craft and do some of the finest photography that there is. So I hope that I can be an encouragement to you, and there are some simple things in this lesson that I think we can all take to heart. It's even a good reminder for me. There is a story of two lumberjacks, and one is this very huge, powerful guy, and the other is a short, skinny fella. And after the whistle is blown in this competition to see who could chop down the most trees in 3 hours, the first thing the skinny lumberjack did was to sit down and begin sharpening his axe, tooth by tooth. The big lumberjack just sat there and laughed. But now the question we have to ask is, of those two guys, which was the one that won the competition? Well, I'd like to suggest that we'll go a lot further if we keep our axe sharp. In other words, we don't simply rely on the point-and-shoot method of photography, but learn some of the real mechanics of what makes photography really good, so we can take the little cameras, the digital things that we have, and even some of the better cameras we have, and give them the most potential in our lives, in our work, in the families that we live in, and so forth. We're going to look at some of the basic elements of composition, of perspective and angle, and we're going to take a look at exposure, light, and color. And we'll try to see how the lens that we're using and the focus of that lens plays an important role in our photographs as well. Who is the audience for these photographs is another thing we're going to consider. What do we want this particular group of people we're going to show our photos to go away with? As far as beginning, I want us to consider the following phrase: meaning is use. One of my favorite mottos in life. What do you think this means? Well, it means that a symbol or a thing, even a word and a photograph, says nothing outside of its context or the way in which it is being applied. For example, the phrase, take it to the bank. Well, that could mean different things in different contexts. For instance, if I'm counting my daily earnings at my sandwich shop, it's going to mean something completely different than if I'm fishing with a friend out in the middle of the river and I say, take it to the bank. Well, the same thing with photographs. Some photographs are going to emphasize one element over other elements, and this will cause your photos to say one thing or say something completely else. The question is the meaning of your photograph getting out? What are you emphasizing? Color? Texture? Is it the size of something? I'd also like you to understand something very important. Photography is four-dimensional. I was on my way actually to the from the capital of Albania, Tirana, and I was at a roadside stop. While I was waiting to get some lunch there, I was watching this bird coming back and forth to and from her nest. Well, I had been watching Mom come home to feed her kids at least three times before I finally decided I was going to time her intervals. Once I knew how long it took her to come back after she had been hunting for food, I just set up, and I waited for her return. I was there at the right time. Time is that fourth dimension. By the way, a few of the shots I've included in this lesson were taken in Albania during a trip I had to this beautiful and amazing place. This illustration should explain something we've all seen if we've ever taken any higher math. We are aware of the first three dimensions. We sometimes call them the x-axis, the y-axis, and then depth, the z-axis. Basically, they are coordinates in space. Yes, a photographer must have good equipment and must get his camera to the right place or space, but there's yet another dimension, time. He must be at the right place at the right time. That time is the fourth dimension. Now, let's say you're out there taking photographs, trying to get to the right place at the right time. What kinds of things should be in your mind as you're preparing to photograph the world around you? You should first of all ask, what's happening here? What am I really watching? Does this fit into my assignment? Planning is a good thing to do. What is the big picture, or what's the broad impression of what's going on around me? And how can I get a photograph that will express that? What is the smaller picture, or the tiny details and nuances? Pencils on a desk, hand motions of a person speaking, cigarette smoking, details, nuances, smaller, finer things. What do you see that is absolutely compelling? Something that's very interesting, perhaps something that you've never seen before, or you think others haven't seen before. What shows what the subject, the person you're photographing, is experiencing? Can you see evidence of their feelings? If you do, can you show that evidence? What are they looking at? Maybe you should look at it too with your camera lens. And what's another angle or perspective on something you've already photographed? Higher, lower, left, right?